Okay, that should about cover things. Okay, boy. It's all right, boy. Yeah, that's it, boy. Boy.
Arthur.
I ain't even gonna ask where you've been.
I reckon you two are made for each other.
Made for each other?
Stand it. It's not for me. I'm designed to float. Not for all this land. It's too much of it. Just too much of it. No wonder your whole lot went crazy. You gotta head out to the sea. Even old Dutchie, it'd be good for him.
How did you get on, Herr Morgan?
Called in on the smallholder, Roble. Didn't even speak English.
Good, very good.
My pleasure.
Well, if it's pleasure you're after, there is one other. This farmer preacher fellow I met in Valentine, Mr. Downs.
The opinionated little do-gooder? Yeah, I know the one. I certainly know the type.
Thank you, Herr Morgan.
There's no need to thank me. Like you said, it's pleasure I'm after.
He's more slippery than he seems. I've tried being polite. Don't take any nonsense.
Nonsense? Me?
If he doesn't have the money, beat him.
Well, I usually do.
I know. I know.
It's actually pretty good. 100 years ago, we'd have been indentured men. My people, peasants, starving in a field someplace. My mamas were in Lincolnshire. My daddies were outside of Rotterdam. At least that's what they told me. The modern world is ugly. But the old world was worse. Our job is to make a better world for ourselves. Not go backward, but go forward. With hope and dreams. Seriously. And that hope begins now by being hopeful and happy. So cheer up, all of you, cheer up. Ooh.
Dear Arthur, I've written this letter 100 times or more, and I cannot get it right. It's me. You know it's me from the bad handwriting. I know I said when we last spoke, and I was going off to get married, that we would not speak again. I know I said a lot of things, and I meant them, I suppose, at the time. But I'm not so proud as to not speak to people who care for me, or cared for me. I've been in Valentine for a couple of months. I had some bad luck, and, well, it's a long story and not an interesting one. But I am here for now. I saw a couple of the girls, or whatever the polite term is for them, that ran with you and your associates in town. And I heard tell of a man who sounded like you. I would love to see you again, if you could spare me a little bit of your time. I'm renting a room at Chadwick Farm, just north of Valentine. Yours, Mary Linton.
One night when I was frisky from too much port and whiskey, like waves on the Bay of Biscay, I began to tumble and roar. My face was red like a lobster. I fell and broke.
This isn't exactly an enchanted forest, this place, is it?
No. I wonder why they called it Valentine. Almost perverse. Seems polar opposite of romantic.
Well, I don't know. Some lady I was speaking to in town told me about a curse.
A curse? Now, nothing's more romantic than a curse.
Exactly. Prince turned into a toad, lovers into stone, entire country turned into morons. Curses everywhere.
What's Valentine's curse?
Well, I didn't quite understand what the woman was saying, on account of her being a bit of an idiot, but some about a massacre and a last surviving Indian cursing the county.
Well, if they massacre people, then they deserve to be cursed.
Of course.
But what was it? Was it just bad luck or bad weather or something else?
About an eagle or an owl in a gravesite. I didn't really get it.
Well, I think it sounds very interesting.
Thank you.
Folks seem really happy now.
Sure.
This is everything. The whole world is in a smile, Arthur. Remember that.
Mr. Arthur, I told Dutch I feel I should tell you. I saw some of Combs' boys riding around.
Down here? What they want?
I have no idea.
Do they see you?
I don't think so.
Okay. Well, thanks for letting me know, Kieran.
Mm-hmm.
Haven't received anything from you in a while, Mr. Morgan.
All right, Pearson. Don't you overcook this now, Pearson.
This is going in the pot. Good job, Mr. Morgan. This camp could do with a few improvements. Why don't you take a look at my ideas? I'll need some more materials before I can make something like that. Ah, yes, that'll be much appreciated.
It makes you feel a bit more like home.
Ah, hello, Mr. Morgan.
Mr. Morgan, you saved my life, and I'm very grateful.
Don't mention it, Reverend.
I made a fool of myself.
We've all done it.
I get so confused and angry, and then I hear God laughing at me, and I get even angrier, and, well, I'm a real prize dolt. I know it.
All right, well, I should be getting on.
All right.
Yeah, I'll stay there, boy. Yeah, okay, boy. Okay, boy. Let's go.
Would you be interested in some friendly competition? I've come all the way north from Mexico to challenge a real American gunslinger. You him?
Me? A real gunslinger? Let's find out.
Okay, man. That's what I like to hear. Look, man, rules are simple, okay? Whoever shoots more of these bottles wins. Just draw your gun and aim when you're ready, all right? Shoot! Easy, man. Perfecto! Hijo de puta!
Damn it all!
How the hell did you beat me, huh? Ugh.
Better shot, I suppose.
That didn't make me happy at all. How about we raise the stakes, huh?
All right, let's do it.
Aha! That's a good call, amigo. All right, real simple. First one to hit 4 flying birds wins. Stand near me, and as soon as they come out, it's anyone's shot. Be patient. Ah! There they go! Shoot! You can shoot, huh? Here it is, okay? Man of my word.
Appreciate it.
Sure. Better watch out next time. You'll see.
Good boy. Yep.
Yeah.
Chick Matthews.
Oh, no, not me, sir. That's the greenhorn over there. Oh, and there he goes.
So long, long shark.
Damn it! Hey! Get back here! You owe us money! Come on! Easy, boy. You're okay. You're okay, boy. Boy! That's it, boy. Good boy.
Let's go, boy. You're all right, boy. Okay, boy. Yep. Easy now.
Just my luck.
God damn it. All right, boy. Yeah, okay, boy. Okay, boy.
these ain't short.
Hey there!
Why's it always gotta be such a goddamn performance with you? Now, I told you I'd get you the money next week, and I'll get it.
If you didn't make it this week, who's to say you'll make it next?
Don't you take that tone with me. I thought you said you loved me.
I do, but what I get paid ain't enough for one person, let alone two. Your money's gotta be your problem now.
The only problem I got is this bleating going on in my ear. Now lay off it, Lily. God damn it.
Lily, where's our money?
What?
That loan you took. It's payday.
I'm sorry. I don't have it right now.
Well, then, I guess we got a big problem, don't we?
Cooper, give him what you've got.
I ain't giving him nothing except a lesson in
damn manners!
Son of a bitch! Steal that, it's a debt. Oh, damn it.
Ain't my concern, no, sir.
A word of this to anyone, and you'll be real sorry.
No! Please, no!
I won't ask you again.
Don't do this!
All right. I hope we understand each other. Damn it, just get out of here.
You're a son of a bitch! All right, fine. I'm out of here! Just gonna disappear!
Yeah, that's it, boy.
Hey now, what are you doing here?
Just minding my own business.
You better get now. You